and it might knock me out.
You can go parachuting with that one.
Oh,
no,
the boy with big knickers are on the rise, with one shopping platform reporting a 60% rise in sales during lockdown. So, granny pants, skimpy thongs, anything in between, where do you stand?
Look, back in the days, yeah, you could do all of this, but now I'm like, no, like, maybe a little Brazilian thing to the side, but no. You know what the thing is with this, it disappears on me. Like, I'm going to be real. One time I had on thongs, yeah, had on these, not these ones, they're not mine. I had on some thongs, and I'm a fluffy girl, and I, you know, I left something downstairs, a cream. I came out my bedroom, my daughter saw me, she was like, Mom, you've got no knickers on. I did have knickers, it's just that all the bits had folded over, so obviously the belly had folded to the side, so you couldn't see the side of the front, and the front and the legs were squashed together and the belly, so it just looked like I had no knickers on, but the thongs was in there saying, help me. It was in there somewhere. And I said to her, I said, look, Mummy has got, look, I lifted. I said, Mummy has got thongs on. What are you to that? What are you talking about? From that day, I thought to myself, I'm not wearing this no more. I'm not wearing, they're dangerous. I'm not wearing that. No, I'm not going any asking people to find thong. No, I'm not doing it.
It could be a whole new game.
I can't say this anymore.
Absolute mess.
I can't breathe.
Sorry, I'm just being real with you. Okay.
So, a bigger pant.
Yes, big.
Like, there you
That's
go.
That's what I'm talking about. These actually might be mine. Woo!
We pulled ourselves together now. We're all ready for him. As a judge on MasterChef, Greg Wallace is used to serving up some spicy criticisms to amateurs, professional chefs and celebrities alike, including our very own Judi. And tomorrow night, Greg is back in the kitchen with a new helping of MasterChef The Professionals, dishing out more advice to the hopefuls. And Greg's with us now. Hey, Greg.
Judi!
Yeah!
How you doing?
You're right, sweetheart! You could have pushed me through to the finals, now.
If I'd known you'd had those knickers on, Judi.
How are you, Greg? Lovely seeing you, babes.
I'm all right, honey. I'm all right. Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Do you know what's so funny, Greg? So obviously, you know, we were all championing Judi when she was on MasterChef. She refused to tell us how well she was doing. A little bit put out, I have to say. Little bit put out about only getting to the semi-finals. And then she heard all the nice things that you had to say about her. All changed. You were a big fan,
weren't
you?
She's a great cook. Caribbean sunshine on a plate, that girl.
Oh, fantastic. They need a proper knife and fork to serve me up. I know, babes. Thank you. I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Great cook.
So, Greg, obviously, you host all the different versions of the show. What's the difference, you think, between, you know, the celebrity version of MasterChef, the professional version, the so-called normal version? What's the difference?
Amateur version, people like really changing their life. The celebrity version, Judi, like, great girl, is good fun, really, really good fun. Professionals is just on a different level. I think it's actually a window into the soul of the obsessed. Yeah. I mean, the food is just at a different level. And remember, unlike the other two, these are people's actual careers. I think there's a lot more on the line with these ones.
Is it more stressful, do you think? Because obviously you've got the stresses of someone who's having a go at something that they're not used to. That's stress, a different kind of stress. But for someone whose reputation is on the line, does that take it to a whole different level?
Sure. I mean, you know, the rewards are huge because there's a lot of light shining on them and it can really help their career. But of course, they are, as you quite rightly said, putting their reputations on the line. Mm. You know, they have brigades that work under them. They have people that employ them. You know, it is their reputations. Mm. It's enormously stressful. I mean, I'm the friendly one. You know, you have to face Marcus Ware and Monica Galetti.